Now, what about determining the stage? Because that's probably the next question a patient would have is, or you have to speak to the patient about, is that stage one, stage two, stage three cancer? How do you determine that?
Right, so again, you know, a lot of the staging is done by imaging. If you go to one extreme of the spectrum, patients with metastatic disease will typically see signs and symptoms of, or we see imaging that suggests metastatic disease. Someone who has a tumor in the pancreas, but may also have a tumor in the liver, or a tumor in the pancreas, tumor in the lungs. So that's one extent. Patients with earlier disease, we may or may not know the staging until after surgery, right, where we can really assess the lymphatics. But by and large, when we get CAT scans or we perform MRIs or we get endoscopic ultrasounds to assess the area, we're looking to see, is a tumor, what's the size? Is it infiltrating local structures? Is there any evidence of enlarged lymph nodes, which may or may not be involved by cancer? And importantly, do we think that there's anything that's spread to any other organ?
Now, we have a graphic that's actually going to show us the different stages of pancreatic cancer and a little bit of what you were talking about, doctor. Can you touch upon these and a little bit of what we're seeing in each stage?
Right. So stage one is really one of the earliest forms of pancreatic cancer. And this means that the tumor is confined to the pancreas. It hasn't begun to grow outside of the pancreas. And all the lymph nodes, once removed, were negative. The cancer didn't spread to the lymphatics. Stage two is a little bit of a mixed bag. Here we have patients with, again, tumors that are confined to the pancreas, but some may have begun to kind of grow outside of its confinements, but haven't involved or impinged on other structures that would deem it unresectable.
Okay.
But these patients is a subset that may have lymph nodes that are positive. If someone tells you, I have pancreatic cancer and I had surgery, by default, they're either stage one or stage two, right? And I'm saying this because the key thing about stage three is that these are patients who have a tumor that is growing outside of the pancreas and is locally invasive. Right, locally advanced. This tumor is going outside of the confinements of the pancreas and it's involving structures near the pancreas, which deem the patient unresectable. Someone
like
who can't have an
operation.
Not so much the lymph nodes, more the vessels that are around the, that are sitting behind the pancreas. So it's a locally advanced process, but they don't have metastatic disease. The disease hasn't spread outside of the area where the pancreas is. And stage four means that the tumor has spread anywhere else, whether that be the liver, the lungs, or the peritoneal cavity.